Welcome all. I think one of the I think recently a lot of personal parents were pinging me in private. They wanted to understand the difference between why certain ghees are very expensive in the market. I'm talking about A2 milk based desi or nati cow ghee. Okay, so A2 is, again, it includes desi cow as well as buffalo is also A2. Not many don't know that. So both has therapeutic and beneficial to health, our body, and you can have it as per your need. If you are from hill station where there's a lot of hill region, you are there, buffalo based ghee or milk might be helpful. If you are towards the coastal, you might not need it. It depends on you and the body. So let's come to the question, why, how do you know whether that's a good ghee or not? You can either test it in the lab, which is going to be expensive. But you can ask certain questions before you buy a product, particularly for the ghee one, which I want to share it. See, for making 1 liter of ghee, you need at least 45 to 60 liter of milk, proper milk, cow's milk. Some say 35 liters also they can make 1 liter of ghee. It depends on the cow's that fat content, how much it produces. It changes from season to season. It changes from cow's delivery, first baby, second baby, third baby, changes. There's a lot of things factor. So average of 30 to 40 to 60 liters is what we can take milk to produce 1 liter of ghee. And cow doesn't produce all the 50 liters when you want it, right? They collect it over a period of time. So morning, mostly in the morning time, they give it for the calf. In the evening, they take the excess milk out, or depending on how genuine that Koshala guys are and how genuinely the cow is giving the excess milk out of grace, we don't know. On average, normal Indian nati cow would give you 1.5 liters to 2 liters. That's it. Or there are some breed which will give you more, but there are only some breed as an exception will give you more. That is not the standard. 1 to 2 liters is what the standard is. So that 1 to 2 liters daily you calculate it, like say another month for you to calculate the, collect the milk, and it has to be turned into a curd, they ferment it, and then manual churning has to be done, and then after 30 days another, like say another 2-3 days, they churn and take the butter out of it. That's another 2-3 days of work, and then they remove the butter separately and the buttermilk separately, and this part they boil it to a certain temperature, and then you get the ghee. That it's a long process, 55 days of labor, 55 days of a guy sitting there, 25 days of milking the cow. If you calculate it, on an average, a good decent quality of desi cow's ghee will definitely not cost you less than 1700. Definitely not less than that. A milk which a kaushala nowadays they produce, all the food, everything, good healthy food, good music for the cow, anything, they are doing it not as a business, still they would take around 50-55 rupees, their average production cost would be. So calculate, let's take 50. So 50 into 50 is how much? It's almost like you know the cost of it. So calculate. So 25 liters, 30 liters, if you calculate, that itself will be 1000 or 2000, 1000 rupees for a milk itself, the total, and then the labor and a lot of other things. So below than that, definitely I really suspect that how can they make a pure cow's ghee. Like I said, oil means it will be more than 350 or 400, in that range below. Because simple math, you just see the raw material calculation and just see if you want to recreate it. Maybe with mass production you can reduce the cost, but not extraordinarily. The small chunk only you can reduce it. So that is the logic of behind the ghee. So that's, if you just check the pricing and see, and then you will know by the taste and the smell you can do it. But now I even heard they add a certain scent into the ghee which will give you that fresh naughty kind of thing. So it's, don't believe in the sense. Sometimes it cheat. They can cheat us. Actual test would help you, but even for the ghee, there is no proper test. You will have to go to CFTRA or somewhere. Even they don't know exactly. I spoke to them in Mysore, and they are not sure exactly which quantity in ghee I have to test it. They asked me, "What do you want me to test in ghee?" They said, "How do you define a good quality ghee?" I said, "No, it's all AgMark and all the symbols, standard parameters are there. We will also do it for you." So it's still a vague, only until you know a person who makes it, you can't believe it. So that's what I know a little bit about ghee. Just thought of sharing with you. If you have anything specific, feel, let's continue our discussion in WhatsApp and Facebook. And if you have any new topics, let's just ping me in private. I'll definitely, if I know, I'll share it. See you in the next video. Thank you.